Have you heard about the forgotten mission of Apollo 12? Well, I'm going to teach you all about what happened and why it's important. Hey, I'm John Williams, and I am in the Virginia Air and Space Center in Hampton, Virginia, and I'm standing next to the Apollo 12 space capsule. Now, not many people know about Apollo 12 because after Apollo 11, the whole program lost steam and no one really cared about it. So I'd like to share the whole mission of it and give you a good insight on why this mission might actually be better than Apollo 11. So Apollo 12 launched on November 14, 1969 with the crew of Alan Bean, Richard Gordon, and Charles P. Conrad. So when it launched on a Saturn V, the president was even there, and it launched in a big thunderstorm. And for some reason, NASA never aborted the mission for another day. They literally launched in a huge thunderstorm, and as the rocket left the tower and leaped into the clouds where no one could see it, it got struck by a huge bolt of lightning that knocked out the whole computer that was calculating how the rocket was going to fly. So the instrument unit took over, which had all the preset flight plan into it, and that's what took the astronauts to space, so they did not have to abort their mission. Because if they aborted, the whole program could have been canceled. So, if we come over here, we have some cool facts about the Apollo 12 mission. So what's interesting about the Apollo 12 mission is that they landed on the moon almost exactly where they were told they were supposed to land. In the Apollo 11 mission, Neil Armstrong overshot his original landing spot by miles and he landed in a boulder field. Very unsafe. But on Apollo 12, they landed pretty much perfectly where they needed to. And guess what? They landed right next to the Surveyor 3 lunar lander, which was a lander launched in the early 1960s to test if the regolith, which is the sandy stuff on the moon, was just a covering for a big sinkhole, or if it was just a small covering with a big rock under it. So when the thing landed and it did not sink into the surface, and it took pictures with this camera right here, it even took a sample with this scoop right here, the moon was deemed safe to land on. So they were sent, the Apollo 12 astronauts were sent here because why not recover some pieces that have been suffering under the moon's harsh weather patterns over the last few years. So when the astronauts landed, they took this camera and they took the scoop and they took it back for research, and they are on display in, I don't know the place, but they're here for everyone to see. So again, it landed 535 feet from Surveyor 3, which is unbelievable. Now, Alan Bean was the first to set a good record. He was the first ever human to fall on the moon. Isn't that great? I'm sure he was happy that that was always under his belt as an achievement. So that basically sparked a lot of videos of astronauts falling and getting mad about it. Whew. So the lunar module was called Intrepid, and the command module was called Yankee Clipper. So the astronauts named these capsules because they named their spacecraft that because, well, NASA told them not to choose a name like Snoopy, which is what the Apollo 10 astronauts chose. They wanted them to be a little bit more professional. So that's really funny. And the lunar module actually is still on the moon. The bottom section of it, the landing stage is on the moon. The top stage actually was crashed into the moon for basic science so that astronomers could look back at the moon and see if they could see the debris field of where the lunar module crashed into. So this is a really amazing piece of history. And thank you for spending your time learning about the Apollo 12 capsule and mission with me. And if you want to see more content like this, click the subscribe button and just check out the rest of my videos. Have a great day. Please subscribe, share our videos, and excitement about space with everyone.